Hi, I'm Barbara Graceffa. I'm a local interior decorator doing business as Secretary of the Interior. You might recognize my name because I write for the Quincy Sun, a decorating column. In addition to my quilt show for the month of August, I am doing a couple decorating classes at the library, so I hope you can join me in August and September for lessons on decorating tips under $50 and big ideas for decorating small spaces. I first started quilting right after the bicentennial, when quilting had a resurgence as a craft. And I think I actually made my first quilt in 1980 when I was still in college. I had no money to buy my fiance a nice Christmas gift. So I was a sewer in the past, so I had lots of scrap fabrics left over. So I made him a scrap quilt as a Christmas gift. And I really just got hooked. I enjoyed the creative part of it, the putting the colors together, and I then took advanced quilting classes and lots of books, taught myself, and I've just been hooked for many, many years on doing quilts. I think the oldest quilt that I am displaying, I made in 1985, shortly after Phil and I were married. It's called The Carpenter's Wheel, and it's one of the larger quilts on display. It's teal and white and gray, and my brother's a draftsman, so a carpenter's wheel is typically like a 12-inch square, but I had him blow up the pieces to make one giant square. So you'll see that on display. In fact, I won a blue ribbon at the Marshfield Fair for that quilt. It was viewer's choice, so it was on display, and the people who went to the fair chose that as their favorite. Another quilt on display is called Love Those Lilies. It is what we call a fractured quilt. I chose a couple pieces of fabric that they call cheater cloth. It's a printed fabric with lilies on it, so I think I bought three of the panels that are exactly the same, and I cut them up. And then I cut out some of the lilies and appliqued them on this quilt. And I added a nice big batik orange and yellow appliqued sun in the upper left-hand corner. So it looks like the sun is flowing over my favorite flowers. Another quilt on display is called Cathedral Forest. And that has a lot of sentimental value to both my husband and I. My husband's great aunt was a nun, and she wore the old-fashioned long black habits. And family members had bought her fabrics to have the habits made, and another aunt gave me the leftover fabric. So that fabric, the black background fabric, is used in this stained glass quilt that's called Cathedral Forest. So it actually, from afar, it looks like a stained glass quilt. But the forest part comes in with the black background and the white fabrics too. So if you stand back, you're going to see white tree branches and black tree branches. And that is one of my favorite quilts. I give a lot of my quilts away as gifts, but this one I never will. This hangs in my home almost all the time. A lot of people ask me, how long does it take to create a quilt? For example, the stained glass quilt. I did that on vacation one week, and I actually kept track. It was just about 40 hours to put together this wall hanging. That's maybe 40 by 60 inches long. And but other quilts take a lot longer. It depends on the intricacy of the pattern, whether or not you're making a scrap quilt or it actually does have a pattern that you have to follow. So I tend to do more wall hangings nowadays, so sometimes I can finish them in a weekend. Sometimes it takes quite a bit longer. There are all different kinds of quilts. In my display this month at the library, you'll see both traditional and contemporary quilts. Traditional are the old patchwork quilts that your grandma probably had. Sewn together from squares or diamonds or triangles, typically with calico fabrics with tiny little flowers on them. I started out that way. Many of my quilts were like that. I created a lot of scrap quilts, meaning with leftover fabric from other projects, so that the color choice wasn't a big concern. But as I developed more quilts and color choice is important. And then more recently I've gotten into contemporary quilts, raw edge applique, meaning you don't have to tuck the fabric under for a smooth edge. You'll see a nice cranberry raw edge applique flower quilt that also uses denim for more texture. How do I choose what I want to make? Inspiration comes from all different sources. I'm a big fan of Pinterest. I find inspiration there. I go to local quilt shows. I'm heading to one in Hyannis soon. And I see artists from all over the world actually display their work. So I bring my camera with me, and sometimes they have to kick me out of the show. I'm there so long finding good ideas for my next quilts. If you're interested in quilting, I say start slowly. Get yourself a basic book at the library. It will teach you what tools you need other than a sewing machine. There are certain rulers that are helpful, certain cutting tools that will help you make a quilt more efficiently. And do something that you like. Create something for your own home. Choose colors that you can hang on the wall or match your current bedroom colors. Choose something that comes from the heart and do it. Just do it. Give it a try.